Today we're going to discuss the data monitor. This helpful monitor can be custom configured to display factory as well as custom sensor inputs. For the advanced user, I'll show you how to set up some custom data sets that can be recalled at a couple clicks of the mouse. Let's take a deeper look at the software and I'll show you how. The data monitor is located in the lower left-hand corner of your software screen. By clicking on the right arrow at the top right corner of the data monitor, or the left arrow, it will allow you to toggle through different sensor parameter views. If you click on E, this will allow you to bring up the data monitor setup table, which will allow you to custom edit the data monitor to fit your particular needs. If you see a green check mark next to a sensor reading, that's just an indicator that it's already assigned to one of the available sensor views. That doesn't mean you cannot add it to an additional view. If you want to change the priority of the sensor readings, you can do so by simply left-clicking and holding and dragging it to the position that you want it to take priority in. You can also rename a sensor heading. In this case, instead of saying sensors, I'm just going to go to something pretty generic, like stuff. If the sensor reading is in bold, that indicates that it is currently associated with your given global folder. If it's not bold, while it is an available sensor reading, it's currently not going to be an available option with the global folder that's loaded. You can scroll on the bottom to view different sensor parameter readings, as well as some of your custom inputs. In this case, I'm going to take a look at input 1. Input 1 currently is not being utilized, but we're going to go ahead and create something real quick to show you what happens. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cancel, go to input 1, and I'm going to create a dome pressure sensor input. I'm going to enable it, and in this case, I'm just going to use a 5-volt Holley sensor. So I'm going to go in and configure, and for my sensor type, I'm going to use 100 PSI Holley pressure transducer. If I go back into edit my views and I toggle over, I will now see that dome pressure has replaced input 1. And I can then assign that as required, and you'll see now that it, since it's assigned, it does have a green check mark. You might want to start from scratch. To do so, you could do clear all. You can then assign the sensor parameters that you want to view as they meet your needs. You can also select autofill, which will pre-populate some common sensor readings. As you can see, this data monitor is a pretty flexible tool. It goes a little bit further than that because a common thing you may run into is working with different vehicles. There may be a specific set of parameters that you want to view, but you don't necessarily want to take the time to go in and change those around each time you go to work on the vehicle. What you can do is click on Data Monitor File, get down to Save As, and it will give you the ability to save as many different data monitor configurations as you choose. So I'll go to Monitor 2. I'll go ahead and save that. Then, in order to change between them, with a couple mouse clicks, I can go back to Data Monitor File, Open, and I can go back to my factory default if I choose. This also gives you the ability to email a data monitor file. To do that, you can go to your Documents folder, go to your Holley file, in this case, V4 Software, Data Monitor Configs, and then you can simply copy and paste that monitor configuration to an email. You will find that the general layout of the editing features holds true with not only the data monitor, but also with the strip chart functions as well as the data logger functions. For more Holley EFI tech tips and videos, go to holley.com.